Hello, boys and girls. It is time for a writer's workshop. This is Miss Alpine here. Today, we're going to continue talking about opinion writing, and we're going to look at the difference between facts and opinions, and we're going to try to understand how facts can help create our opinions. So just to review, we know that an opinion is how we think or feel about a topic. And we could have an opinion like, I feel all students should read 20 minutes a day, or I believe dogs make the best pet. And we've already talked about that in an opinion essay, a writer needs to clearly state their opinion about the topic. They need to convince the reader to think or do something. They think a certain way or do something they want them to do. They need to support their opinion with convincing reasons and facts. They're going to use linking words and phrases to connect ideas. And then they're also going to have a conclusion that wraps it all up and possibly asks the reader to take action. But a lot of times we may get stuck because we might have a topic that we don't have an opinion about, or maybe you can see why people would think both sides are correct. So in that case, we want to start using facts and text evidence to make our opinion. So facts or evidence-based opinion writing is opinions that are based on and supported by text evidence or facts. So in the past, in kindergarten, first grade, and second grade, every time your teacher asked you to do an opinion writing, it was always based on just how you felt about the topic. Like they might ask you, what is your favorite season? And you think back and you go, oh, I love summer. And you give reasons why summer is your favorite. Maybe because you get to go swimming, you like the hot weather, there is no school. And it's all based on just your own personal feelings. But starting in third grade and going forward, your opinion has to be based on evidence. On evidence based off of text or facts that you've learned through research. So today I thought, how about let's learn a little bit more about facts and what the difference are between facts versus your opinion. Let's watch this video to learn a little bit more.
Fact and Opinion for Kids by Teaching Without Frills. What is a fact? A fact is something that is always true. Facts can be proven. We can find facts by doing research in books or on the internet, or we can even do research of our own. Here's an example of a fact. Dogs need food and water to survive. This is a fact because it's always true, and you can prove it by doing research. So, what's an opinion? An opinion is what you think or feel about something. It cannot be proven. And your opinion might be different than someone else's. Here's an example. You may think dogs are the best pets. You may feel like dogs are so cute. But someone else may think, no way, cats are the best and they are way cuter. So now let's see if you can tell the difference between a fact or an opinion. Apples are fruit. Fact or opinion? Yes, this is a fact because it is always true. How about this one? Apples are delicious. Right, this is an opinion. Some people think apples are delicious, other people, not so much. So if you're trying to determine if something is a fact, ask yourself these two questions. Is it always true? Can it be proven? And if the answer is yes, then that's how you know it's a fact. If you liked this video, then check out the Teaching Without Frills channel for even more. And if you're a teacher, you can follow Teaching Without...
Okay. So she gave some good information about facts and opinions.
Fact and opinion.
All right. So a fact can be proven. So we can prove something if it is a fact. And a lot of times if it's a fact, you're going to usually find some numbers associated with it. So you might find a fact like that tortoises can live up to 150 years. Well, usually if there's numbers involved, that means that we can prove it. Therefore, it's a fact. But an opinion is just how someone feels or what they believe. So, for example, when you look at facts about Oreos, there are nutritional facts about Oreos. So you can actually find how many calories it has or how many grams of fat. Maybe the types of Oreos could be a fact. Where Oreos are sold is a fact. And then there's some other statistical information about Oreos, like maybe how many Oreo packages are sold each year. But an opinion, on the other hand, we could say something like Oreos are the best cookies on the market. Well, can we prove that? No, that's just my opinion. That's maybe how I feel, but you might feel something different. Or Oreos are my favorite types of cookie. Well, believe it or not, that's not true in my case. But you might feel that Oreos are your favorite types of cookies, so therefore it's an opinion. All right? Or they should make blank flavored Oreo. Maybe you want peppermint flavored Oreos. Ew, that might sound gross to some people, but someone else might think that's true. So that's an opinion. But the main thing I want you to think of is that facts, when we learn more facts and do some research, that's going to help us to create our opinion about a certain topic. For example, if you were given the topic, the opinion persuasive writing topic of should PE be required for all students? Well, you might feel a certain way about this. Maybe you love PE, but the person next to you hates PE. Well, who's correct? I don't know. How about let's do some research and find some facts? And let's say you found the fact and you said, oh, Miss Alpine, I found and did some research that shows that exercise leads to relaxation, improves concentration, memory, creativity, and mood. Oh, that's a pretty good fact that says PE is good for you. But then you do more research and you find another fact. And it says that only 1 in 3 children are physically active every day. Wait, so if kids aren't doing PE, they're not getting any physical activity. And the fact before that tells us that physical activity really helps them to create or to be more creative and have better concentration. Uh-oh, that's another fact that maybe tells us that kids should have PE every day. Then you find one last fact, and it says, being inactive, which means that you're not active, being active leads to heart disease and type 2 diabetes. Wait, so this fact says that if I'm not physically active every day, I could actually get sick and have heart disease or type 2 diabetes? Well, all three of these facts really make me feel like maybe PE should be required for students every day. So based off of these facts that I found doing research, now I can create my opinion, and I could say, based on the evidence, I believe PE should be required for all students. So what you're going to do today is we're going to look at the difference between facts and opinions, and you're just going to do a fun little activity here. And in this activity, kind of make this a little bit larger for us, it says you're going to read each sentence and decide if it's a fact or an opinion. Then you're going to drag and drop these boxes over here into the gray space below each sentence. For example, number one says a bee colony can have anywhere from 10,000 to 60,000 bees. Well, I'm going to ask myself, can I prove this? And will it always be true? Well, look at the numbers. Remember, I said if we see numbers, that most likely this is going to be a fact. So if you think it's a fact, you're going to take one of these and you're going to drag it and drop it under number one. But number two says soccer is much more fun to watch than football. Well, can I prove that? No, this kind of sounds like how someone feels. And personally for me, I would way rather watch football. So since I don't even agree with this, I'm going to say this is someone's opinion. So I'm going to drag and drop opinion right there. And you're going to continue reading questions or statements 3 through 10, and you're going to either drag or drop an opinion or a fact to each one of the gray areas here. All right, remember, facts can be proven, opinions cannot. It's just how someone feels. But we're going to keep thinking as writers, as opinion writers, that facts can help us create our opinions. All right, let's work on this activity for today. Have fun. Let's go be writers.